In today's demo, I'm going to show you how to set up and sync Trello cards with Unito's Board Sync Power-Up. The first thing you'll want to do is search for Board Sync on the Trello Marketplace. Look for this listing right here, two-way board sync and mirroring. Then you'll click Add, then Add again. And then you'll notice the Settings button just appeared in the middle of my screen. I'll click on that, then Authorize Account, click Authorize again. Just scroll through here if you'd like to read the list of permissions you'll be granting Unito so that it can create and sync cards on your behalf. Then click Allow when you're ready. Click on Got It. Then you'll close this screen right here. And then one thing you'll definitely want to do is make sure that whichever account is creating flows is a member of every workspace that you plan on syncing. Otherwise, you won't be able to find those boards within the Unito interface. So I'll just pause here for a second and set up my board so that my flow creator account is a member of every board. Okay, so now I'm ready to go. I'm going to click on the little Unito icon and start creating a flow. Right here. So create flow. Now this is the Unito flow builder. This allows me to create a connection between one Trello board and another. So I've already set up my account and board on the left, and I'll do the same on the right. So I'll choose my personal tasks board that you can see on the right with the same account name, and then I can scroll through each Trello board that this user is a member of. And then I'll click on confirm. Next, I'll set a flow direction. So this allows me to decide where Unito will create new cards based on my activity in the other Trello board. So our options are two-way between both boards or one-way from one to another. In this case, I only want to send cards from my master events board to the personal tasks board. So I'll choose a one-way flow, but as you'll see later, all cards will still allow for a two-way sync. And now I'm going to set rules. So this decides which Trello cards will sync. We can sync by label, list, member, and then you can choose any label from the original board, the source, and tell Unito that if that label is present in a card, sync it to the other board. In this case, I chose my label internal. You can add multiple labels if you wish, and then either of those Trello cards would sync over. Now I'll just remove the creation date filter. And then below, you can see a list of actions that Unito will take on your behalf in the destination board. So you can choose to set default rules, including list, member. You can assign cards to people automatically. And that's what gets decided there. Now, next, we're going to link fields between our Trello cards. So I'll choose to map automatically, which allows me to start with a pre-built template. And this is where I can see how all my Trello fields relate to each other. And over here, I can configure the multiple or single select fields, such as list or labels, and then see if my options within those fields actually relate to the equivalent in the other tool. So in this case, I'm looking at my Trello lists. If my lists serve the same purpose, I'll want to sync them here. So for example, you can see on the right, I've got an inbox and then all of my months then appear in the personal tasks board. So I want to see then, does the master board follow the same logic? Am I using lists the same way? If so, I'll want to sync them here. But if they're not, you could see here, these are names of events. I'll want to remove this field pairing because the lists don't actually have a relationship, even though it's the same field in Trello. So I'll just remove this from my current flow. See, as you can see here, I've got months. I'll click on the little garbage icon, and that gets rid of it from my flow. If I click on this button here, I can tell Unito to enable two-way updates so that changes to either Trello card will update the other. And over here, you can see my labels. It's the same premise. On the master board, I'm syncing based on departments. So you could imagine that I'm syncing different cards to different departments, but in the individual Trello board, my labels aren't organized that way. So it doesn't really make sense to sync labels in that case. So I'll remove that field pairing as well. And then I'll just quickly go through all of these, set them to two-way sync, and then click on confirm. So this means that, like I said, any changes to fields in either Trello board will update the other automatically. Then I'll click on continue and launch my flow, and then I'll show you what it looks like to create a card in one board and have it appear in the other with board sync. So you can just click on the X in the top right corner to close the flow builder. You can reopen it at any time. And oh, actually my flow is too fast for me. So as you can see here, my conference booth setup task has already synced over while I was talking. So the details that I included, the fields that were actually populated in my demo have now appeared on the right. Any information I include here will appear in the other in both directions. So here is a comment from the original task. I'll click save, and then you'll watch that comment appear on the right. That might take a second or two, and I can also throw in an attachment for good measure. And then while that's attaching, the comment should pop up shortly. And there's the comment, and the attachment should... Okay, yeah, and there's the attachment as well. So you can see how fast Unito syncs data between two cards. Now both boards are up to date. So that same card exists in both boards, and changes to either one will update the other. One last thing I'll show you is what to do if your single or multi-choice fields are related. So in this case, I'll show you two sets of labels that serve the same purpose in a slightly different flow. So when you click on the gear icon, you can then configure these fields. So any community tasks are identified by a label in this case. So I need to tell Unito specifically that the community label on one side is the equivalent to the community label on the other. If I don't, Unito will refer to my default settings, and then it will auto-populate all of my labels with the default label that I've chosen in the previous step. So if your labels matter, or if the choice fields matter, you definitely want to set them up this way. You'll notice also that there's a plus icon underneath add more labels here. That allows me to group multiple field options together in one place. Just in case there were two departments in my context that were very, very similar, that maybe served the same purpose, and then it wouldn't matter if somebody changed the label on the other card, the original would always know that those two were meant to be grouped together. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to reach out to our team and let us know. Thanks for watching.